What's up internet, welcome back once again. I am Manish from RebellionRider.com. Till so far we have seen several examples of anonymous PLSQL blocks as well as named PLSQL blocks such as database triggers. In today's PLSQL tutorial, we are going to learn the concepts of another named PLSQL block. This is also the most requested one on my social media. It is none other than PLSQL functions in Oracle database. Yes, this video is an introduction to PLSQL functions in Oracle database. Also, if you don't know what are anonymous and named PLSQL blocks, then I suggest you to check out my PLSQL tutorial 1, where I explain the concepts of blocks in detail. Find the link on the right hand side corner of the screen as well as in the description. That being said, let's move ahead and start today's tutorial and learn what are PLSQL functions as well as how to create them. So, what are functions? We can define a function as a self-contained subprogram that is meant to do some specific well-defined task. Functions are named PLSQL block, which means they can be stored into the database as a database object and can be reused. That is also the reason why some books refer to PLSQL functions as stored functions. Actually, in Oracle PLSQL, there are two types of subroutines or say subprograms. These are PLSQL functions and PLSQL procedures. The concepts of functions and procedures are very closely related to each other. Where both have some similarities, they have some differences too. We will save PLSQL procedure for future videos and for the time being concentrate on PLSQL functions only. So let's take a quick look at the syntax of PLSQL functions. The syntax of PLSQL function is divided into two parts. First is the header of the function and second is the execution part of the function. The header consists of the signature of the PLSQL function and execution part holds all the executable statements as well as defines the working of your PLSQL function. Let's take a detailed look at this syntax. The keyword create marks the beginning of the syntax, followed by another keyword function, which tells the compiler what kind of object we want to create. In between create or function, we have an additional clause or replace. This clause can help you in modifying the definition of an already created function. Anyways, next we have to specify the function name. This is completely user defined and could be anything which follows the Oracle database nomenclature rules. Followed by function name, we have the parameters. A function can either have 0 parameters or n number of parameters. You just have to make sure to separate all the parameters from each other using comma and enclose them inside the parenthesis. Followed by the parameter list, we have to specify the value which the function will return using the return keyword. With PLSQL functions, it is mandatory to specify the return value. In order to specify the return value, we use return keyword followed by the data type in the header of the function. Yes, you only have to write the data type of the value which you want your function to return. Then we have keyword is. Is keyword indicates the ending of the header of the function. Now, in case you want to declare a variable or a constant, then you can do so right after the is keyword or right before the starting of the execution section. That too without the use of declare keyword. Then we have the execution section of our PLSQL function. Similar to anonymous PLSQL block, the keyword begin marks the beginning of the execution section and the keyword end marks the ending. In between these two keywords, you can write the executable statements and define the working of the function. Do not forget to define the return statement in the execution section. This will specify the actual values which will be returned by your function. And the data type of this actual value must match with the data type that you have specified in the header of the function. That's all you have to take care. And that's it about the syntax of PLSQL function in Oracle database. I have done an excellent blog post on the same topic. There I have discussed PLSQL functions in detail. If you want to read and make notes for your college exam or Oracle database certification, then do check that out. Link is in the description. That's it for this PLSQL tutorial on introduction to PLSQL functions in Oracle database. Do make sure to subscribe as I'm going to show you the live demonstration of how to create PLSQL functions in Oracle database in the next tutorial with the help of a very easy example. Also, if you like this video, then give it a thumbs up. You can also help others in learning as well as support me and my channel by sharing this video on your social media with your friends. Thanks for watching. This is Manish from RebellionRider.com.